Now for some basic MIDI editing. First, select the Wurlitzer Electric Piano on the project page. Now go into the Key Editor by selecting Open Key Editor from the MIDI menu. Let's jump into the Preferences and choose MIDI from the Event Display submenu. You can double-click on a MIDI part, and this drop-down menu will determine which editor will open up. Set this to Open Key Editor, and let's try this again. Close the Key Editor if it's open, and then double-click on the MIDI part. The Key Editor opens. This is your basic piano roll editor. You can see the pitch of the MIDI to the left and the length of the MIDI notes to the right. Down at the bottom of this window, we can see our controllers. It usually defaults to velocity, which is the individual volume of the notes. When we say volume, we generally mean the volume of the whole track. When we say velocity, we mean the individual volumes or velocities of the notes. We can use some of the tools here to make changes and add in notes. For example, use the Object Selection tool or the Arrow tool to pick up a note and move it up and down in pitch or left and right in time. You can see the bars and beats in the ruler just like in the project page. This tool can also be used to lengthen your notes at the end or the start. The Draw tool can be used to draw in new notes or edit the controller data below. When you draw in notes, you can pick the default size of the notes by changing the quantize value here. A tip here is to choose a smaller value, like 16th notes, click and drag, and then let go to get longer values. The Erase tool deletes notes. You can drag select a group of notes to delete them. Mute mutes the notes instead of deleting them, just in case you need them later. Remember, you can always drag select a bunch of notes and affect them all at the same time. The Trim tool trims the ends of the notes. If you hold down Alt, you can trim the beginning. The Split tool cuts the notes, keeping both the start and the end. If you have snap on and a low quantize value, you may find it impossible to cut notes. Make sure you either turn off snap or choose a higher quantize value. If you've made some cuts or just have notes one after another and want them joined together, use the Glue tool. The Zoom tool helps you zoom in. And pressing Alt lets you zoom out. The Line tool has 6 different options, allowing you to draw in notes or alter controller data such as velocity. The Time Warp tool will be discussed later in Level 3 of this tutorial series. If you just want to solo what we're editing in this editor, press the solo button here. This way you won't hear the rest of the tracks. The acoustic feedback button allows you to hear the notes while you're editing them. That's a basic overview of the key editor. In level 2 of this series, we go all the way and give an in-depth look at the rest of the features.